Let me use a yardstick to add and subtract. Really, I'm going to be using a meter stick to add and subtract, but let me talk to Americans for a moment. 5 plus 4 is 9. Watch this. 5 plus 12 is 17. And I can say, oh, 7 plus 13 is 20. It adds and subtracts. I'm not telling you anything new. What about multiplying and dividing? There, we go to logarithms. Logarithms! I can hear people saying, oh, I hate logarithms, I hate it, oh. Logarithms, common logs, were created so that instead of multiplying big numbers, 751 times 982, what you would do is you'd take the logarithm of 751, add it to the logarithm of 982 to get the logarithm of something else, the answer. Look up the anti-log of that, the backwards log of that, to get the result. So instead of adding and subtracting numbers on these two meter sticks, if I replace these with logarithmic sticks, I can multiply and divide. So I've got a pair of meter sticks where I've covered up a couple numbers with the log of that number. The logarithm of 2 is 0.301. So I'm going to cover up 0.301 with 2. I'm going to cover up 0.301 with 2. Well, the logarithm of 3 happens to be 0.48, more or less. I'll cover that up. Look at this. Instead of being nice and linear like this, all the numbers squeeze up over here. That's the way logarithms work. Big numbers squash up over here. And they're real nice and lazy out here. Let's see what we've made here. I know that I can add distances. Let's try it now. Here's the number 2. Here's the number 2. Oh, 2 times 2 is 4. 2 times 3 is 6. 3 times 3 is 9. It's multiplying. Brady, come on over here. Check this out. Instead of having a ruler like this, notice how it's a ruler like here. Here's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And over here is 10 if you really want to push on it. So here's a slide rule, and this scale over here, the D scale, is the important one. Oh, Pi is hiding. Hey, there's our friend Pi. But this one also has 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Let me throw these sticks away, and I'm only going to look at these two scales here, the C and the D scales. Let's just look at those. Let's go one step further. Let's use this cursor. 2 times 4 is 8. Okay, no surprise there. And we can now go in between numbers. Let's try something a little bit more cool. 2 times 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4, 2.5, 2.6, 2.7, 2.8, 2.93. Okay, let's say 2 times 2 and a half. 2 times 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4, 2.5. Look at that. 2 times 2.5 is almost exactly 5. Let's look at between 1 and 2. There's all these extra numbers. 1.5 is over here, but they didn't write the 1. A piece of tape. 1.1. 1.2. 1.3, 1.9, 2, 2.1, 2.8, 3.0. There's pi. 1.2 times 2 is 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4. Okay, it works. 1.25 times pi is 3.92, about. I'll give it just a smidgen right in here, too. So why do I even bother owning a calculator? Well, this is nice. It sits next to me. You know, I can, when I'm sitting here at my desk, I can multiply using a calculator. So, like everybody else, I'm fairly lazy. Let's fix this up just a little bit better. Here, put this over here. Now, I don't need to reach up here anymore. I can just say, oh. I now have an electric slide rule. So when I want to multiply or divide, oh, 2.1, let's just move it back over to here. 2 times 2 is 4. All done electrically. But of course, I need to move the cursor too. Let's multiply 8 times 4. Oh. Oh, 8 times 4 is a little bit more, it looks like 32. It's either 3.2 or 32. The decimal place, I don't care about. I'm just concerned with the numbers. Slide rules don't know about decimal places. Here's 51, 52, 53, 54, 55.5 times 3 to give, oh, 1.67, something like this. The latest advance in slide rule technology.
So I don't have as many as Cliff, but I have various slide rules here. I would say this is my favorite, and I'll tell you about it sometime. But now I want to tell you about Audible.com, who have supported this video. Audible have an epic range of titles, no matter what you're interested in. For example, why not check out Neville Shute's autobiography, which is called, you guessed it, Slide Rule. Shute was an amazing character, not only a prolific fiction writer, but also an aeronautical engineer. And this book is the account of his real life adventures in the world of aviation. Listeners to the podcast Hello Internet, which I co-host with CGP Grey, may also be interested to know Shute has a book called Beyond the Black Stump. And yes, that's also available on Audible. So Audible is offering a free audiobook with their 30-day trial. Go to audible.com/numberphile and you can sign on for that 30-day trial. You can get your free book. And if you use the URL /numberphile at the end, they'll know you came here from the podcast. And when you get your free book, why not go for Slide Rule by Neville Shute? You can even put it on your phone. You can listen to it when you walk the dogs, which is what I'm about to do now. Yes, you heard right. I'm going to take you for a walk. Yes, yes, you can go for a walk as well. Yes.
Breedy, check this out. It has a speed control. I want to go slow. I can go fast. Want to go right way?